My fascination with resilience goes back a long way. The center is now a way to expand on my curiosity.
Our mission at the Adrienne Arsch Rockefeller Foundation Resilience Center at the Atlantic Council is to reach people, 1 billion people around the world with resilient solutions to climate change, to migration, and to human security challenges. We do that lots of ways, but one of the ways we do that is with arts and culture and storytelling.
The expression, "the show must go on," really means you better be resilient. I first saw Anna Deavere Smith at a performance of Let Me Down Easy, which she was giving at the Arena Stage in Washington, D.C. We developed a very close friendship. And about 4 years ago, I asked, "Anna, what are you doing next?" She said she hadn't thought about it. I suggested, "How about doing your next program on resilience?"
We are so excited to welcome Anna Deavere Smith to our center and to the Atlantic Council as our artist in residence. We knew immediately that Anna's powerful storytelling, the medium of the one-woman show, was something we wanted to deploy for our purposes of reaching people with resilient solutions. It's a pandemic. We're all stuck at home. We're in quarantine. And we had a vision, of course, for something different, for a show. And we pivoted. And so Anna, when she usually embodies the story of the person herself, now she's bringing that same approach, but she's interviewing people and she's sharing their stories with us.
I love doing interviews. When I'm talking to somebody, I'm really trying to get the secret sauce of what they do and how they do it. I know the person I'm talking to knows something about survival that I don't, and that's what I want. I really was fascinated with an Olympic sailor who said that she said, the ocean is a great teacher of humility. And I just love that because I've been thinking a lot for many years now, about at least a decade, that confidence is overrated. We need to give doubt a try. And so I think that, you know, this idea of understanding what you're up against and to approach that with wisdom, but also humility. And I think nature brings that to us. You know, we all know that art really does creep into the crevices where facts just miss the point, where they miss the whole picture. And so I think that art and artists have something to offer the work of the Resilience Center. And also because, at least in my case, I'm getting really personal with individuals. And so the Resilience Center will be thinking on a very big scale, which is essential. And I'm really looking at specific human beings.
The saying, "a picture is worth a thousand words," could be expanded to say, "a performance is worth a thousand words." It will be the most powerful and memorable way to think of resilience.
We need resilience now more than ever. So stay tuned, the stories of human resilience starting on March 4th.